Right on. Get him on. Fix it up. Bloody beautiful. Underage little fuck. Sit down. Look at you. There you go, mate. That's a fucking good haircut, mate. Eh? That's a beautiful haircut. What are you going to do when the ferret wants her cunt back? That's a beautiful haircut. So
what do you reckon?
Yeah. Good looking young cock. What do you think of him for a young cock? You're a good looking lady walking through there. Let's have a look what your cock looks like. Where's he sitting? Show us where your fine young cock is sitting. Is that him? It's a good looking young cock you're with? She's beautiful, yeah. You're a good looking lady. You make me feel like a poor old battle-weary Taliban soldier seeking refuge in your pubic cave. Make me feel like a... Oh, you shut up, you drunken little fuck. Look at you, trying to act like you're clever and you're just a pissed, bald-headed little fucking prisoner. Look at you. These blokes have got something intelligent to say and you're sitting there pissed in your fucking Hawaiian detective shirt, looking at me and ordering one drink. Fuck off home, you fucking weasel. Look at you. I was down on your mum like a beaver on a hunk of wood. She had an ass like an anaconda swallow on a fucking piglet. And it was beautiful too, and I'll be back for more of that. I like your mum's fat ass. Give her my regards. I didn't have time. I was only there 5 minutes. Nothing wrong with your mum. I got a vision of her now struggling up out of the sunken lounge room. It was like a wildebeest getting up a mud bank with a croc gnawing on her ass. Give her my regards. They reckon you never forget how to ride a bicycle, but in his mum's case, it's like riding a penny farthing down the fucking beach. Give her my regards. She got me interested in genetically modified food. In the split second, they can make a mango taste like a vagina. I'll fuck off to Queensland and live there and eat fucking mangoes all night. I've bloody been driving like a bastard, Trent said. It's a bloody... Honey, it's a fucking Arab in here. Look at you with your bloody Taliban beard. That's a bloody nice little Taliban beard. You ladies have got a lot of good-looking cocks with you, haven't you? Eh? Beautiful ladies. Make me feel like a poor old retired... What, are you looking for coins now? Make me feel like a poor old retired suicide bomber. Hoping to use my small pink fuse to set off a pleasurable explosion in your underpants. Poor old fucking Arab there. Tell you what, I know it's a cliche, everybody says we're lucky to live in this country, aren't we, eh? How lucky are we? How'd you like to live in one of those fucked up Middle Eastern countries? Eh? How'd you be? I'm watching the bloody SBS the other night and there's all these little Iraqi kids are about that high and they're all going, kill Americans, kill Americans, little bastards. They all like to see them all born with two fucking heads. Saddam could go broke buying caps for the little cunts. Kill Americans. Oh, you fuck off home too. Look at you sitting down. Sit with him. Piss in his ear and clear his head. You know fuck all. You're sitting down there because it's dark down there like a bloody monk's butt plug. I fucking know you. I've seen you around town. Yeah, your friends all told me before the show out there, they told me about you, bloody, you wanted to get a tattoo and you all went to get a tattoo and they got a nice eagle on the muscle and you got a target round your asshole. Because they told me about you. Because I know, I fucking know you. Last time I was here, I got raped. Three big fat lezzos got me down and flogged me with a hunk of bong hose. That's why I come back. Big fat lezzos might be going, oh, Red, roll out your rug. And I'm going... What about if you're a lezzo trendsetters who... was home early from work. You're a lezzo home early from work and you're thinking to yourself, me husband's late today, she won't be here for a while, I'll cook a nice curry. So you cook up a beautiful curry and you cut up a shitload of the hottest chilies you can find, make a beautiful hot curry, and you think to yourself, me husband's not home yet, she's running late, I might lay down and have a rest. And you're laying down and you happen to be looking at a poster of K.D. Lang or someone, and you think to yourself, I might masturbate for a while. But you forget to wash your hands and you burn your hooded warrior on the chili. Your husband comes home, she burns her tongue on your warrior. I think them all up myself. What about if you're a lesso who wanted to have a baby? You invite all your poofter friends around to beat off into a turkey baster. Chuck it in the freezer. Get up in the morning to use it, and another poof you never met just grabs it and fucks off yelling, thanks for the snow cone. Because every time I come to Toronto, I look around and I reckon some of my relatives got in for fuck all. What I reckon. Because I've been driving trendsetters there for bloody Kenny Rogers' son going through there, look.
You got to know when fold. Know when to fold.
You look a bit like Kenny's son. Kenny must have done a lot of rooting around Toronto. He's got a lot of sons there. No, trendsetters. I've been bloody driving for 109 hours without a fucking sleep. 100. Oh, and you just shut your hock hole, mate. Bloody sitting down there. Who cares? No one gives a fuck. Except me. You shut up. You're the only one been looking at me fat. No one cares. Nobody here cares. And you're down there looking at me fat and going like this. Bloody, even the prisoner was looking. Yeah, prisoner. Bloody 116 hours straight without a sleep. My only place I stopped was Nimbin. I like Nimbin. It's bloody good there, but you can't, in Nimbin, you can't tell who's the men and who's the women. I thought I might as well just fuck everyone in the arse. In Nimbin, just root everyone in the arse in Nimbin. I met a girl, got the real big hairy armpits, and I like that. It's like getting two extra vaginas chucked in for nothing. It's a bonus, two bonus vaginas. I rooted her right, left and centre. I like that. I like Nimbin. Nothing wrong with Nimbin. Gyro Gearless, it's a bloody good place, Nimbin. You'd like that there, Gyro, bloody Nimbin. Nimbin's bloody good walking around in fucking Nimbin. I know you from somewhere, but I can't remember where. You been on TV, mate?
No, not yet.
You lying little fuck, you have. You were on TV, I saw you. 3 years for fucking a goat. And your mate got 18 months for acting the goat. Because I know. I bloody recognise people. Sick of this fucking beard and bloody got to wear a... got to wear a false beard for bloody laughs. Just walking around up the street here today going, what are you fucking looking at, mate? No. That's K.D. Lang's bikini line. That's a pubic booster. If you want to top up the spider's legs out the side of your undies. That's a bloody good prop. That. Have a look at me new false ass while I turn around. Put it away. Put in a Tupperware container, Jay. That's a fucking good prop, that, mate. Got that off Judge Judy while I was rooting her from behind. She didn't notice. I pinched her gavel. She was in ecstasy. Didn't notice. I ripped her off for a gavel. I'll take that to Queensland. Give them back a bit of what they fucking give me. That's a good gavel, that. I like it when I get a good prop. You're looking beautiful tonight, sweetheart. Sitting down there, I noticed you when you come in. You make me feel like an old battle-scarred Kalahari lion hoping for one last growl in your jungle. That's how you make me feel. You make me feel like that. And I'll be needing your ass tonight because I'll work mine off. That's how hard I'll bloody work. I'll chuck shit all around the room here. Backstage, you look like your auntie's bedroom after you've been smoking my old pork bomb. Chuck shit around. Oh, well. Hey, how many blokes here tonight like to wear their ladies' underpants back to front? Yeah, and a good idea, prisoner. A good idea. Because it gives you a lot more room in the front for your bunch. And in the back, you get a G-string chucked in for nothing. That's how clever that is. Don't you hate that, ladies? You go to the toilet, forget you're wearing a G-string and half a turd goes on the floor and half in your sock. Don't you hate that? Everyone knows what a hermaphrodite is, eh? Person with two sexual organs, got a cock and a cunt, everyone knows that, eh?
What was it, Rodney?
A hermaphrodite. I think that's right. What about if you were such a stickler for correctness, you start a big argument with a hermaphrodite just so you could tell them to go fuck themselves? Hey, who saw the ABC News tonight, 7 o'clock, before he came out for a laugh? You see? Because Molly Meldrum had a stroke. The whole entertainment's not funny. The whole entertainment fraternity is upset, Molly Meldrum having a stroke. Because now he can only suck a cock out of one side of his mouth. Nothing wrong with Molly. He's a fucking good mate of mine. Get on the piss with Molly, he buys all the drinks. If you like tea, maroon and milk. There's nothing wrong with Molly. Probably thinks he's going to root me. Imagine Molly on my withered old ass. That's why I got this new false ass. Molly's chasing me, I'll chuck it out for a decoy. And while he's rifling it, I'll make my fucking getaway. And you need a false ass too if you ever go for a holiday to England. Those pommy fudge punchers chasing you down the Strand or the Leicester fuck knuckle or whatever it's called. You chuck out your false ass and while they're rifling it, you fuck off. What school do you go to, mate? No, this is not funny. I'm just serious because that's where I think I remember you. What school do you go to? Belmont. Belmont? High? I was the fucking maintenance man there. That's where I remember you from. Because the other kids used to get you down and pull you. I remember you. I remember you when your asshole was no bigger than a shirt button. That's how long ago it was. And now it's a fucking dinner plate. Because I remember Belmont High when I was the fucking maintenance man. On the bloke who gets all the roots around Hexham. I have to. My arms aren't long enough for a pull. I'm the man. Yes, sir. There's nothing a lady likes more than a fucking cowboy. Yes, sir. The ladies love a cowboy. I've been out there in south central Queensland riding those big hump Brahma bulls and I come down to Hexham just to ride the heckler's mums. Yeah, I give them mums a good pounding because I'm a bloody cowboy. And cowboys know how to ride a rough one. Cowboys can ride the roughest ones. Yes, sir. I get all the roots. Yeah. Yes, sir. Shut up, mate. You just pissed off because you got sacked from the council. They caught you out the back of the work hut sitting on a witch's hat flogging your pathetic little willy. That's what you were doing. Out the back of the bloody work hut sitting on a witch's hat playing with your willy. Bloody shut up, mate. Yes, sir, I'm the man. You're just a fucking pinhead. You're probably wearing Ant's cunt for a cap. Go out Friday night, all your mates would be wearing beanies and you'd have to wear a fucking work sock. You're a fucking pinhead. And I'll tell you something. I'm walking around in Sydney, down at Circular Quay, walking around there. Oh, yeah. I know it's supposed to be Kui. I was 29 years old before I found out it was bloody Kui instead of Quay. You grow up in a country town, I thought it was Quay. Same thing, you bloody growing up in a country town, you go to get a bottle of drink, I'll have a bottle of Scoopies. I didn't know it was Schweppes. How do you think there's going to be a bloody German bottle of drink in Bathurst? A bloody German bottle of drink and, oh, I'll have a bottle of bloody Scoopies. I didn't know it was Schweppes. Fife and farf and schlimp and fumf and stink and arschen. Gross and grash and schlump and einer Drexel, dorn and fuck and stink and arschen, schlaf and fumfen. I didn't know that. Here I was in the bloody down Circular Quay and a homeless prick walks up to me. I said, get out of here, you homeless fuck. I said, get some bloody house and contents insurance on your plastic bag full of shit. I said, use HIH, I said. They got nothing, you got nothing, you'd be a nice fucking pair. Get out of here, you homeless fuck, I said. And get a new trolley. Push that one in the harbour, the wheels fuck. And get a bloody Sydney Morning Herald for a bloody blanket. It's too cold for a fucking TV guide, you homeless fuck. Get out of here. Go on, look at you there using a bloody baby sock for a condom. Get out of it, you homeless fuck. I said, all the bloody businessmen got to get their lousy half-hour lunch, I said to him. Sit on the lawn and eat their sandwiches. You get to do it all fucking year. Some hard-working bloke fills his ute with petrol, turns his back for 5 seconds. There you are, sniffing his vapours. Get out of here, you homeless fuck, I said. He said, oh, you got any loose change? I said, I got plenty, but you ain't fucking getting any. I said, get out of here, you homeless fuck. I said, get back in your St. Vincent de Paul clothing bin. And I hope all the rich cunts feed your cheesecake through the hole and you get fat and can't fucking get out. Here I was, and the bloody doctor said, flipped me cock up the wrong way then. You get that? That's the bloody uncomfortableness I go through just for the bloody amusement of my fucking fans. Flip me cock up the wrong way and I got to put up with that. Oh, fuck off home, mate. Yeah, you fuck off and bloody save your money so you can buy more trophies like your mates told me you do. Your mates told me, you weak fuck, you go and buy trophies and get your own fucking name put on them. Your mates told me. Oh, your mates told me before the show. We went around to your house, you going, oh, look, this is when I was a footy player, I was a boxer. Fuck off, mate. I know. Get your, I know, yeah. Your mum still lays your clothes out in the bed for you like a little flat cunt. I know you. The bloody hell's that? K.D. Lang been here trying to get pregnant with my roadies. Fuck off and leave us alone. Bloody hanging around famous cunts looking for autographs. I'll tell you something. Here I am in the bloody doctor's surgery at Circular Quay. I look around. There's a homeless fuck sitting next to me. I said, what are you doing in the doctor's surgery, you homeless fuck? He said, every time I have a shit in the harbour, he said, me turds float. I said, well, what have you been eating there, you homeless fuck? He said, oh, I've been eating wine corks. That's all I can afford, he said. I said, well, you go and have a big feed of sinkers, you homeless fuck. Floating turds I've got to put up with around your place. Around your fucking house, there in the bloody bushes near the fucking harbour. Bloody... Shut up, mate. I wish your ass was a circus and all the homeless cunts got in for fuck all. Bloody yelling out. Yelling out. I'll bet you that bloody Ronald McDonald doesn't even eat his own hamburgers. I bet if you went to the Ronald McDonald School for Clowns, they'd all be sitting around tucking into a dirty big leg of lamb. The only one that eats them is the Hamburglar, and he's a stunted little McFuck about that McGuy. He eats them. He's not a burglar's asshole. He couldn't even pinch a pen off an old lady, the bloody Hamburglar. That's how weak he is. I bet I fucked him in jail 1979. Oh, yeah. I would have fucked the Hamburglar. I'd have ripped his goggles off and flipped his cape over his head. He wouldn't have known who was fucking him. Bloody Hamburglar. Fucking Hamburglar. He's piss weak, the Hamburglar. Oh, yeah, I fucked your father in jail too, mate. I give your father a desperate old prison fuck. I remember him. I got a bloody mop out of the kitchen, mate. Your old man a week. I remember your father. And I cut some broomstick handles off and made him a set of stilettos. And then I pulled his undies up, his ass cracked for a G-string. Got a dish rag and made him a tank top with a broken egg carton for tits. I remember your old man, because when you felt his tits, they fucking crackled. I remember him. Yes, sir, I remember. I had your old man in the shower with a handful of butter for lube, or it might have been hair gel, I can't fucking remember. But I remember one thing, I had to wait for the blokes, because I wasn't that fucking tough.
Oh, yeah, you can whinge all you like, but I fucked your father.
Yeah, yeah, he fucked your father too. A lot of blokes here. How many blokes have been in jail? Hands up. You fuck his father? You did, I know you did. Who else has been in jail? Did you fuck his father? He did, he fucked your father. Everyone fucked your father, now shut up.
Oh, yeah, we fucked your father. Okay, oh, we'll chant it out. After three, we fucked your father. We fucked your father. We fucked your father. We fucked your father.
I'll tell you something. Have a nice game of chess on your Bruce Springsteen shirt.
Bruce Springsteen shirt.
That's a nice...
Hey, little girl, I can't get affection. I got a urinary tract infection. It's you high. My cock's on fire.
I'll tell you something. I'll tell you something. I remember years ago applying for a job at McDonald's. Years ago, before I became a famous McCunt, I remember that. I went, this is true. I went in there and this bloke looks at me and he goes like this. He goes, $3 an hour. I said, did I McFuckin' McHear you, McFuckin' McRight? I said, I'll tell you what I'll do for $3 an hour, mate. I'll have a McShit. You insulting fucking McWeasel, I said. $3 an hour? All I'll do for $3 an hour, I might hang the tea bags under John English's eye shrink. Carry a sugar bag full of butt plugs for George McMichael. $3 an hour. I said, I'll put stink beetles on me cock and shoot them off with a matchstick cannon. $3 an hour? I got some mates who bloody work for Toyota. They're mechanics. They've got to kick in to pay for the coffee to fill up the dirty big coffee urn. How piss weak's that? I got it on the back of the ute the other day. I'm going in McDonald's front door and this bloke comes out and he goes, what do you think you're doing? I said, are you the fucking McManager? He said, yeah. I said, well, I'll tell you what you do, mate. You get your thin ass on the other handle of this fucking McUrn. And you help me get it up on the counter because you've got a sign there that says free McRefills. Now you help me fill up this huge urn, fuck all, like your sign says. And then you help me get it on the back of the ute, and if you spill it on my dog's leg, I'll McFuckin' McSmack you. And change it from happy day to McSad, because it ain't happy when I'm McFuckin' McAfter McCome in here. And I'm glad you got rid of your seven wonders of the week, because I needed a calendar just to know when to piss off back to Brangston. I said, now you got the hide to come out with a McOsburger. It'll take more than a perfectly round, paper thin, anemic, fuck-ass little bit of McBeetroot to make a McOsburger. If you want a fair dinkum Australian hamburger, you go to a little Greek cafe. Because they're the blokes who know how to make the tastiest stuff. I woke up this morning here in the motel room. I was too tired to even have a pull. I had to get the cleaning lady to do it. How long's your auntie been working there, mate? Okay, here you go. Rap song. Rap song. That's how cool I am. See a bunch of young blokes with their caps on backwards. I take all my clothes off. Put them all on backwards. Pants, coat, shirt, shoes. Drive me four-wheel drive 60 k's backwards. Everything back the fuck. That's cooler than cool. I have a beer, I spit it back in the bottle. I have a root, I don't put it in, I pull it out. Then I put it in again, so fucking forth. That's how cool I am. Everything back the front. Oh yeah, root your mum, she gets behind me. That's cool, that's back the fuck. You look beautiful tonight, sweetheart. You do, you're a beautiful young lady. You look very pretty tonight. You make me feel like a poor old explorer dying of thirst and hoping to find a damp patch in your river bottom. That's how you make me feel. Oh, three beers with a nice looking lady on them. That's a good spot you got there. You make me feel like a poor old retired magician hoping to hide my dove under your skirt. Okay, here you go. Rap song. Rap song. Hang on. When you do a rap song, you got to do an introduction. Like, imagine the American Music Awards and Snoop out of Doggy Doo Doo, fucking Taipan or whatever his name is. He's getting ready to get his award, and the MC has introduced him, and he's gone, yeah, I want to introduce Snoop out of Doggy Doo Doo, Puff out of fucking Black Snake. And. Snoopy fucking dog shit got his adder and his fucking snake, and he's and he's won his award for being a shit hot bloody rap singer, and Snoop Adder comes out and he goes, I want to thank every goddamn motherfucker. I want to thank the Lord Jesus Christ, goddamn motherfucker. Because I'm good. I'm really fucking good. I'm good. I'm really fucking good. We were shooting one time on the Bogan. When we come across a nice fresh pig, Grogan, it was all brown and thin with a wrinkly skin. It looked like fucking Paul Hogan. I'm good. I'm really fucking good. I'm good. I'm really fucking good. I'm going to make one up about a salmon. Okay, you go. Got to think about this. Have to stop the show and think about it. Oh, shut up yelling out, mate. I fucking know you. Oh, yeah, and I'll give you a break because your auntie saved me life. Yeah, she saved me life, mate. Because in Australia, you got to be real careful. A lot of people get bloody sun cancer. You always got to get checkups and stuff. In Queensland, you get bloody sun cancer and stuff. And I was in bed with your auntie, and I looked down. Sure enough, there was an ugly mole on me cock. She saved me. Your auntie saved me. Now fuck off home, mate.
I'm good. I'm really fucking good. I'm good. I'm really fucking good.
A terrorist by the name of Bin Laden. Terrorist by the name of Bin Laden was thinking while he played with his Harden. He said, I'd like to root a mammal or a fucking old camel or a dog tied up in me garden.
I'm good. I'm really fucking good. I'm good. I'm really fucking good.
Bloke by the name of Osama was tongue-kissing a fucking old llama. He said, me favourite root is an old work boot and a fucking big umpty back Brahma. With camel shit all over his banana.
Don't you hate it when your dick wakes up 2 hours earlier than you and says, get up, you bastard! Get up! Get out of bed! Where's all the vaginas? You're hiding the muncher! They're in your pockets, aren't they? Get up and piss me! Don't you hate that, gentleman, when you meet a nice girl in a bar such as this, eh? You go home, you have a little root. get up in the night to go to the toilet, forget to take your condom off, it fills up with piss and fucking explodes. Don't you hate a gentleman when you're on the piss all the time, right? I said no. Come home one night, really drunk, you're in bed with your lady, you're having a root, and because you're so drunk, you happen to urinate while you're having a root. And your lady says that it's such a lovely, warm, wonderful feeling, she expects it all the time, and you're going to become a fucking alcoholic just to keep her happy. So there's these three AIDS germs living inside the vagina of an 86-year-old prostitute in Bangkok, right? Well, that's enough. I won't tell the joke. Three AIDS germs, they're happy AIDS germs. This old prostitute's only got one customer. An old bloke comes once a week, every Thursday, 5:30. These little AIDS germs get a telegram from their cousins who live in a poofed ass in Subiaco. They said, you blokes better be careful. That old prostitute's getting the new AIDS drug. Where are you going to hide? And one germ said, I will hide right in the very end of the leathery old nipple. No fuck will find me. So the other one, we're going to hide. He said, I will hide in the gout blister in a fucked up old foot. So the other one, we're going to hide. He said, I don't about hide. When the 5:30 pulls out, I'll be on it. There you go. There's a joke for you. Start and an end, a fucking joke. It's a fucking good one too. Did you see that special? Did you see that Michael Jackson special on TV the other night? Who saw that? Eh? See him dancing around there with his bloody big razor nose. Eh? I'll say one thing for the little cocksucker. He can dance like a duck on a hot plate. Can't he? Eh? I forgot about him and all of a sudden I see him again. He's dancing like a bastard. I thought, you're a dancing fuck. I thought. Just seen the paper. Last bloody Sunday, trendsetters. A pissant little bit of printing. That big. Michael Jackson, that little woozle, he spent $7 million. He purchased the movie rights to Dr. Doolittle. So him and a bunch of kids can play with the push me, pull me. He wants to change it from Dr. Doolittle to Dr. Little Doodle. Isn't he a weasel? No wonder his missus divorced him. He'd be wanting to kiss a two-tone little fuck wearing a spray painter's mask. He should change his name to E.H. Holden, the fucking little fuck. He's a fucking fuck. No, it was the other way around. He wanted to divorce her. Because she wouldn't wear a cub suit and strap on a 2-incher. So a good thing in the TV, the Barbie doll people come out with a little Barbie doll for little disabled kids. I thought that was a good thing. And in contrast to that, you've got Michael Jackson coming out with a doll in his own fucking image. As soon as a kid plays with it, it gets a fat. I need a beer now. Here's a drink, mate. Problems with my grandfather. He wrote every joke that was worth a fuck. He wrote the joke about the poor bloody hard-working Tom Price miner. He had to go to a funeral in Perth and he's scared shitless to fly. And he had to get in his bloody work truck, got his dog on the back and drive all the way from Tom Price to Perth for his brother's funeral because he was shit scared to get in a plane. And he's driving along, got Ajax, his dog on the back, calls him Ajax because he can fucking clean anything up. And he gets to Perth. He pulls up out the front of the funeral home and Ajax got off the truck and started rooting this woman's poodle. And they couldn't get him apart. They put the hose on him and everything. Miner jumps out of the truck and he starts rooting Ajax up the ass. Everyone said, what are you doing? He said, he can give it, but he can't fucking take it. Grandfather wrote that joke. Thought it up himself. Don't you hate it, ladies, when your computer goes down on you and your husband won't? Don't you hate it, ladies, when you buy a packet of Libra pads and as well as having wings, they also got a beak and tail feathers? And if you don't put them on straight, they pick you. I reckon they'd be great, those Libra pads with wings. You get up in the middle of the night and fly to the toilet. Got your wings? You could fly around the house. Those whispers wouldn't be worth a shit. You wouldn't be able to hear what the fuck they were saying to you. Speak up, you're whispering. Psst, psst, psst. I knew a young bloke had a job in the supermarket. He's only been there a week. The woman got on the mic. She said, Barry, bring me down a carton of Tampax. And he thought she said thumbtacks. He's back on the mic. He said, oh, you want the ones you hammer in or you push them in with your thumb. Fucked him off. He only lasted a week. That's how stupid he was. How stupid is that? Don't you hate it? How many ladies here tonight have ever been so drunk, so pissed, right, that you're trying to put in a tampon and you're so drunk, you stick it in your ass? Shame, shame. Naughty little Rodney talking about tampons and asses. I'm going to have to try that to give credibility to my fucking statement. Don't you hate it, lady, when you go out for... Ladies, you go out for a dinner and show, it's a smorgasbord, you're in the toilet changing your tampon, the bloody string breaks. You've got to sneak out to the server and pinch the tongs. What's even worse, you've got to sneak them back into the beetroot without anyone catching you. Don't you hate that, ladies? Don't you hate it, ladies, when you go to a disco, you run out of tampons and you're going to use a wine cork? You're dancing like a bastard. It pops out, the bloke behind you picks it up and goes, nice vintage. Now listen, trendsetters, you know what I reckon? Oh, a lot of people accuse me and my audiences of taking the lowest common denominator and not doing comedy that has any intellectual value, right? Now, I got one. Not too bad. Thank you. Nice one. What a bonus. Got a fart off into the mic in Toronto. Now, what I was saying was, you get accused of bloody taking the shortest road and doing jokes about, you know, cocks and cunts and farts and stuff. But I know, as far as I'm concerned, my audiences and me are capable of fucking much more. So I want to do an audience participation song now, and I'll teach you the men's part and the women's part, and then we'll sing it all together. Just to show that we're capable of bloody thinking man's comedy. There it is. Okay, gentlemen's part. Your hairy hole. I love your hairy hole, your hairy hole. I love your hairy hole madly. I love your hairy hole. All together, gentlemen, you ready? Your hairy hole. I love your hairy hole. Big fat cock, I love you, big fat cock, I love you, big fat cock, madly, I love you, big fat cock. Ladies, together, ladies, here you go. You big fat cock, I love you, big fat cock, big fat cock, I love you, big fat cock, madly, I love you, big fat. All together, hairy hole and fat cock. You ready? You big hairy. Well, g'day, trendsetters. The album's finished. I reckon it was a great album, that. I reckon it was a real hornswoggler. But I've got a couple of bonuses for you, as usual, a couple extra things. Not stand-up comedy. You know, I really love writing limericks. I started writing them when I was a kid, you know. I reckon they're a lot of fun. I reckon you should all my fans out there should write limericks. They write some limericks about what's going on, you know, like friends and
about things that happen and that, like just but the gross ones are the only ones that are memorable. No one ever remembers a clean limerick. But write them, send them into my website and we can all laugh at them. You know, I reckon they're really good fun. I wrote my first one when I was a kid. I had a mate, Warren Winsley, his name was, and me and Warren, our parents took us for a week's holiday to Palm Beach, the school holidays. Anyway, we had this maths teacher who hated us. I was lousy at maths, so the concentration span of a fucking bee. I still have. Anyway, me and Warren are having a surf, and we got these little black rubber rafts they used to hire out, and we're coming in on a wave, and I hit this bloke in the back and knocked him down, and he come off spluttering, and it's this teacher who hated us. Mr. Garibaldi's name was. Anyway, we used to call him Gara. Gara for short. And he's on his holidays, eh? He's probably all strung out, the poor prick, and he's trying to forget, you know, about kids and stuff. And here we are, the two kids he hates, and knocked him down. And he was fuming. And he comes up spluttering and that, you know. And he gets sight of us and he goes, "You fucking little bastards," he says. He says, "Get out of here." So anyhow, you can imagine what we did. We spent the rest of the day trying to go close to him to torment him. Anyway, I wrote a limerick about him. That was my first exposure to it. Oh, I suppose I was, I don't know how old, 11, 12, 13 or something like that. And wrote the limerick, and wrote this limerick. A mathematics teacher named Gara was rooting an overripe marra. But much worse than this, his favourite wish was to fuck a tiny little brown sparrow. Well, okay, trendsetters, as I said, I hope you like the album. I reckon it was a good album. Here you go. Give us some limericks. I'll see you on the circuit. Bye. He's got a limerick.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Oak flats, like kneeling on nice soft doormats. He liked telling jokes to young horny blokes and nibbling the end of their fats.
An old Chinese butcher, Wing Fat, was rooting a big Persian cat. When the cat got excited, he found out it bited, so he had to downsize to a rat.
An old lady who came from Marengo got bit in the ass by a dingo. The sores on her bum seemed to slow her down some, and she couldn't sit down to play bingo.
Cocksuckers never in their bite, so sing us another one, just like the other one. Waltz me around again, Willie.
A famous puss licker named Ivan said this lady will soon be arriving. He said, "I'm a mad growler and a fierce arsehole prowler, plus sneaky and always conniving."
An old priest we call Father Roy on a scouts camp was acting real coy, 'cause after lights out we don't have a doubt, he inspected the bum of a boy.
The horny old priest has a stiffy. His one greatest joy is to pull up a boy. The thought makes him come in a jiffy. A trucker who came from Quinana had a smegma encrusted banana. To get it all clean and make the thing gleam, he had a toothbrush well spread with Vipana.
An Egyptian slave named Elijah told another slave, "I'd like to ride ya, 'cause I feel a bit queer being chained up in here, so I might as well pump one inside ya."
A kid who had a fruit bat for a pet took it one day to the vet. It had a large mole round the rim of its hole, and when fingered it got really wet.
There's a limerick.
Me. I was getting a blowjob last week from a woman who lives at Falls Creek. She bit me too hard, now my cock it is scarred, and the most painful when having a leak.
Where's your limerick? You got one?
I got one.
A bloke who worked for Fisher and Paykel rode to a toilet block on his cycle. As he stood at the trough, he heard someone cough. I think it was George fucking Michael.
A bloke by the name of Osama was rooting this big hairy llama. He then fucked its head till the poor beast was dead, then asked for some oil to embalm her. Wipe off the puss of your llama and come up to Queensland, we'll give you a free hand. Get yourself fucked by a brahma.
A bloke who fucked Dame Edna Everage said as a root he was average, 'cause drag queens are weird, plus they have a faint beard and do anything after a beverage. Oh, that was a nice little one. Sing us another one, just like the other. Sing us another one, do.
A pedophile cunt from Geelong got a jail sentence that wasn't long, but while in the nick he got belted with dick and they severed the end of his prong.
A stewardess who worked for Garuda was a lezzo with a fucking big hooter. She said, my girlfriend complains that her ass is in pain, 'cause my nose rubs too hard when I root her.
He's got a limerick. What's your name? What's your name?
I'm not telling.
What's your name?
A priest minding kids at a camp told a boy that his undies looked damp. Hand them here, son, I won't look at your bum, and dry them in front of this lamp.
The horny old priest has a stiffy. His one greatest joy is to pull off a boy. The thought makes him come in a jiffy.
He's got a limerick.
Yeah, I know.
An old camel fucker named Osama was tonguing the hairy boat of a llama, but the very jealous beast, or was it such a jealous beast, begrudged him the feast, so it shit in the murdering cunt's pajamas.
An old asshole licker named Moore spent all that he had on a whore. He said, I hope you're all wet with a rancid old sweat, 'cause I'll tongue you until you are sore.
A lady who came from St. Christian was in love with a sailor, a midshipman, but when he sailed away, she just went astray and sucked off in turn the four kinsmen. A soldier whose first name was Seymour could not get a root up in Timor. You may think it's shonky, 'cause he fucked a wild donkey, and when he pumped off a load it went hee-haw. A donkey just near Tijuana was rooting a lezzo named Lana. But much more than the mule, she loved a big rubber tool that she popped underneath her pajama. A farmer who came from Nagambi liked to bumfuck a midget named Mandy. He said, it feels good when I stick in my pud, 'cause her legs are so short, thick and bandy. Ah. The horny old priest has a skiffy. His one greatest joy is to pull off a boy. The thought makes him come in a jiffy.